Yeah, good morning, everybody. Let's continue with just review capacitor first. Yeah, capacitor stores electric charge, right? Yeah, this stores electric charge. Yeah, charges 전하. This is my charge. So, charge generates electric field. This integration of electric field is potential difference. Eh? So, electric charge generates electric field. In a circuit, yeah, I have a. We said a circuit is what? Circuit is a circular path of electron flow, right? You can say round path. So we are talking about the electron. We are not talking about the atom, right? So it's a round path. The starting point of a circuit must be the same as the end point of a circuit, right? This is my circuit. It goes around the circle. So capacitor, say, I have a circuit like a voltage source. So this VST is a waveform. You know, waveform is what? Okay. So I have a waveform generator. Usually we have a function generator. Okay. You have equipment called a function generator. So I have a source resistance of 50 ohm here. This is my function generator. Okay. Function generator terminal. And then I just connected my capacitor there. Yeah, it can store charge here, plus Q charge, minus Q charge there. And then, say, it will generate some voltage, VT. Yeah. Then this charge is, see, if I have IT there, I should have IT there, right? Yeah, this one. So I can say voltage source, resistor, 50 ohm, and capacitor, it generates a circuit because it is a circle. See, charge is integration of current flow, right? I can write that this is a tau instead of a T. Okay, I tau d tau. So that current flow accumulate the charge on this metal plate. So, however, there is no charge flow between those two metal plates, right? There is no electron flow. So actually, current is zero in between two metal plates, But we just define displacement current. This is assume. I will assume there is a current flow directly between two metal plates of a capacitor. That's a displacement current, right? Displacement current is displacement current. Yeah, this is my displacement current. There is no current, but if I assume displacement current, then I have KCL working. My KCL is working. Okay. So that displacement current ICT is nothing but dQ over dt. Yeah, that's the same as this ICT is the same as that IT, right? This IT. So my KCL works here. Okay. Then it's very convenient. Displacement current. That is actually wrong placed current. Wrong placed current. It's very convenient to analyze the circuit. Okay? Yeah, that's the view. Any question? Okay, let's continue with the inductor. So we have a basic element R, L, C. Yeah, this R just dissipates the energy, right? So for the linear resistor, I have Ohm's law. And for the linear capacitor, I have a Q. My Q is, this is a definition of capacitance, right? The ratio between stored charge and voltage developed across capacitor. That's the definition of capacitance. Yeah, so here, see my I, that displacement current is, so linear capacitor, my C is independent of V, C is a constant. So I have this relation, right? Okay, let's talk about the inductor. So any conductor has an inductance. That's the nature. So what's the property of inductor? Faraday law. Yeah, Faraday law. Faraday found out that, see, for example, I have an inductor circuit here. I attached my inductor here. Okay, this is my inductor. So A and B. Yeah, Faraday found out that, see, yeah, my IT will flow like that, right? Yeah, he found out, say, voltage across between, so I assume, I will have some conductor here, but I will neglect the inductance there because it's a short. So I have a long inductor in this circular path. So I just concentrate, my inductor is only this right-hand side circle. So he found out that actually this is actually magnetic flux. Eh? So this B, you know, any current flow will generate the magnetic field, something like that. So this is my H field, right? No, it will go like that, H field. You know, electric charge will generate, see, I have electric charge here, plus Q. It will generate electric field, right? A point source electric charge will generate electric field. However, there is no magnetic charge. So just current. Current will generate Yeah, this is current. The current is actually loop, right? Current is a loop. A loop current, this is my loop current, will generate a magnetic field, H, right? So B equal this magnetic permeability mu times H. So if I integrate B for a certain area, that's a magnetic flux, right? Magnetic flux. So this psi is my magnetic flux. Okay. So let's see. This is magnetic flux. Let's see. Okay. All right. So let's talk about this first, okay? So if I have a current I flowing like that, so, you use right-hand side rule, right-hand side law, and it will generate a magnetic flux going into the screen, right? Is it into the screen, right? Here I have some magnetic field coming out of screen, but it will be canceled by this one and that one. Okay, I have a small magnetic field outside the circle. I have a strong magnetic field inside the circle. Okay, so Faraday found out that the voltage drop. So if my current is increasing with time, my current is increasing. Say, I just assume I increased my voltage Vs with the time, then my current will increase with the time. Then there will be a voltage drop generated between A and B to cancel this current increase. So there must be some positive voltage must be developed here. V must be positive. V is kind of increasing, positive voltage. Then see, this V and that this voltage drop will try to reduce IT, right? So if my current IT is increasing with the time, positive voltage will develop. The potential VA is larger than VB. To cancel, it tries to cancel the current increase. That's the nature. So better they find out that by law, see, this VAB equal the this is integration of B inside this area dS, right? So yeah, then VAB actually we can see that. Okay, so this is definition of potential difference, but see, we must be careful. Say, inside this, along this conductor, my electric field is zero in this metal plate. So if I integrate electric field along this path, this is zero. However, if I integrate electric field from here in this way, I have some positive voltage will develop here. Okay, my KVL doesn't work inside the inductor. Okay, because if I integrate along this metal conductor, that integration is zero because E is zero inside the conductor. But if I integrate along this path, some other path maybe, this path or whatever, then I have a positive voltage. So let's just see. By the right hand side rule, current is flowing like that. My flux B is going into the screen inside the circle. How about y ds? What's ds? Oh, ds is, see, if I integrate, let's see, in here, if I integrate along this path, if I integrate along this path, my ds is also going into the circle. Okay. Then this value is positive. Then say my VA is like that. So, you know, voltage drop. What's the voltage drop? Is it? Let me see. It must be positive, right? Let's see. Oh, sorry. Actually, Faraday law is this one. This one, okay? This one. See, if I integrate electric field all around this circle, so it means what's this? Okay. So if I this is my dl, direction of dl. So if I integrate electric field around this circle, so then it means, see, I have to integrate electric field from B to A EDL plus if I integrate electric field from here to there, that's zero, because E is zero, right? So then it said minus D over DT, and then because I am my DL direction is here, so that's my DL direction, is it right? Yeah, my DL direction. So my DS is pointing inside the circle. So this B DS is this is a positive, right? This is a positive because B and DS pointing in the same direction. So this is actually minus D flux DT. Okay. So this happened to be what? Minus VAB, right? By following this definition, is it right? So here, my potential difference, my potential of A with respect to B, that's a voltage drop between A and B. I mean, my polarity is like that. So if my current is increasing with the time, this flux is increasing with the time, this voltage is positive, okay? The inductance is defined like that. In a linear inductor, the ratio of magnetic flux with the current, that ratio is inductance L, right? So here, my VAB will be L di dt. If I is increasing with the time, di over dt is a positive, VAB is a positive, it tries to reduce the current increase. Okay? So inside the inductor, KVL doesn't work. But if I assume this is just inductor, AB, L, and then it follows this rule, this relation, then my KVL works, okay? Question? No? Okay. Huh? Question? VAB는 지금 여기하고 여기 사이에서 요 서큘러 패스, 그러니까 이 서큘러 패스는 요렇게도 갈 수 있고 요렇게도 갈 수 있고 뭐 다 갈 수 있죠, 그죠? 그러니까 이게 서클이기만 하면 되잖아요, 그죠? 그러니까 지금 하나는 이건 따라가야겠지. 이걸 따라가야 지금 근데 요렇게 따라가 보면 플락스가 또 요 좀 제한이 되겠죠, 그죠? 내가 뭐 이 패스를 따라가면 블락스는 여기만 적분을 해야겠지. 이쪽은 적분 못하고. 그래서 가장 쇼티스트 패스를 따라가는 게 맞겠지. 플락스 이 플락스 적분을 내가 다 하려면 이 DS가 그럼 요 원으로 생각하면 제일 좋겠죠. 예? 그래서 지금 어쨌든 내가 이 원을 따라가는 이선 적분을 해야 되잖아요. 그죠? 그러면 그선 적분을 하는데 이쪽은 아무리 따라가 보니 0이잖아. 그죠? 0. 그죠? 왜냐하면 도선, 메탈 컨덕터 안에 E는 제로거든. 그래서 지금 제로가 아닌 건 여기밖에 없었어요. 지금 이 뒤에를 따라가, 그러니까 B2A잖아요. B2A. 요거 뭐, 지금 요건 정확하게 지금 안 맞아. 요게 저, 페라데이 로죠. 페라데이 로에서 이렇게 다 따라간 선 적분의 합은 요만큼이 되죠. 그죠? 그죠? 그래서 요게 마이너스, 이제 그걸 또쓴 거잖아. DL이 이렇게 따라가면 DS도 이렇게 들어가 버려야 됩니다. 그, 저, 라이트 핸드 사이드 룰을 쓰면은, 그죠? 그래서 B하고 DS는 같은 방향이다. 그래서 얘는 플러스다. 같은 방향이니까. 그죠? 오케이. Any other question? 그렇죠. 무슨 말인지 잘 모르겠는데. 어쨌든, 지금 이건 이 폐곡선이잖아, 그제? 그 폐곡선을 내가 이런 원으로 가정을 했죠. 요 폐곡선. 그죠? 그래서 폐곡선을 했으니까 B에서 A 갔다가 A에서 B 갔다가 이렇게 하죠. A에서 B로 갈 때는 열심히 해봐도 이게 안에 0이었잖아요. 0. 얘가 0이니까 E가 0이니까 이 패스를 따라가는 선적분 값은 0. 0. 그죠? 그리고 B에서 A는 요건 0이 아니야. E가. 그래서 B에서 A는 해놨죠. 그죠? 근데 요게 by definition 얘가 저 마이너스 VAB가 되잖아. 그죠? 그러니까 지금 이 커런트가 인크리스 하면은 이 일렉트릭 필드는 어디로 향하냐 하면은 이렇게 이 방향으로 일렉트릭 필드가 향하게 되겠죠. 그죠? 그 E가 거꾸로야. 그 B에서 A로 하면은 얘가 저 마이너스가 되겠죠. B에서 A로 이렇게 하면은 그죠? 이 값은 마이너스야. 이 값은 마이너스가 될 거야. 일렉트릭 필드가 이렇게 향하고 있거든. A에서 B로 향하고 있어, 지금은. 네, 그래서 마이너스 값이 나오고. 그래서 V가, 어쨌든, 일렉트릭 필드가 이렇게 향한다는 것은 V가 포텐셜이 더 높다는 거야. VAB는 플러스라는 얘기야. 그죠? 네. Yeah, so we can just model this like an inductor air. Okay, we don't care about the what's going inside. So inside the KVL doesn't work. However, if I assume this inductor, yeah, so it's a voltage drop is LdIdt. Then my KVL works. It's easy to analyze the circuit. Okay. So let's talk about impedance. Yeah, impedance, see, we can say my impedance. Impedance is, see, the difficulty of current flow for a given V. Yeah, this is my definition of impedance. So in this inductor, my V is L di of dt of I. So for DC, anything, no current, no change. If I have a derivative, that derivative is zero at the DC. So my impedance is zero at the DC. 인덕턴스 이제 숏서킷 at DC. 오케이. So 인덕턴스 has no resistance, no at the DC current flow. But if the current changes with the time, that inductance tries to resist the change. It does not want to change. Nature does not want change very much, right? It does not. It tries to cancel the change. If I have my signal IT is something like I zero exponential j omega t. Yeah, this is a artificial one, right? This is not real. So it's you already know this is cosine omega t plus j omega t. So each component is real. But if I assume this complex number, it's very easy to analyze a phase relation. Okay, so I assume my current flow is just this does not have any time dependence, right? I zero is a constant, no time dependence. Then, yeah, di dt is what? Di dt is just j omega i t, right? Then my impedance of inductor, impedance equal j omega L. So at omega equals 0, impedance is 0. So if my IT is something like I0 exponential ST, yeah, this S is a constant, right? Complex number. This I0 is a constant, independent of T. Then my impedance is just SL. Okay? So this is a general sinusoid. This one is a more general sinusoid. S is a complex constant, right? Yeah, here, for this relation, my S is J omega here, but I have a real part also here. This is a very general Laplace transform. This is a Fourier transform. So my impedance is SL. Similarly, in the capacitor, for the capacitor, my impedance is J omega C, 1 over J omega C, 1 over SC. In the resistance, impedance is always R. Okay? Question? No? Okay, let's talk about the RL circuit. See, so my R is 1 ohm, my inductor is 2 henry. So I have a voltage source here. I have a 1 ohm resistor there. I have an inductor. This is a circuit notation for inductor. Okay, L. Yeah, I want to calculate current here. Yeah, for example, see, my VST is a unit step input. So this one is so for T negative, this voltage is 0. So my IT should be 0. It remains at 0. So this satisfies the relation. You know, here, see, I know the relationship between this inductor voltage and current, see. My inductor voltage is L 2 henry di over dt, right? So if I apply K, so voltage drop across the resistance is Ri, right? So I have a relation here. So I have a differential equation here. For T negative, my Vs is 0, then see, for T negative, this is 0. So there should be any change. So di dt is 0, so my it should be 0, okay? So there is no change for long time. Time derivative must be 0. It's like DC, right? So for DC, this inductance is a short circuit because impedance at the DC is 0, right? So if this is a short circuit, yeah, I have just resistance only, right? So this voltage is 0, current must be 0 because this is a short circuit at DC. Yeah, for T positive, see, this suddenly become 1, right? For T positive. Then what happens? Yeah, see, let's see. We will notice that my current is continuous with the time. See, we'll see capacitor charge and inductor flux. It is continuous with the time. It means my current is 0, so at the T 0 positive, my current is 0 also, right? So actually you can see this is just capacitor voltage and inductor current is also continuous with the time, right? Q equal C times V, flux equal L times I. So capacitor voltage, inductor current are continuous with the time. Okay? So anyway, see, yeah, at the T equal 0 positive here, at this moment, what happens? See, this voltage is 1 volt, and this current is still 0. Voltage drop across inductor is 0, right? And then the voltage 1 volt will drop across this inductor. Then, see, by this relation, this voltage is 1 volt. So my di of dt will be 1 volt. So, you know, if I plot current here, my current is 0, and then, say, it will increase with the time because this slope is 1 volt, right? It starts from 0. So if the current increase a little bit, so then voltage drop across this resistor may be 0.2 volt, okay? Then this voltage will be reduced to 0.8 volt, right? Then my slope will reduce a little bit. Then this voltage will be 0.4 volt, because current increased a little bit. Then this voltage will be 0.6 volt. My slope is reduced a little bit. So it keep on increasing until this voltage becomes 1 volt. So that's what? That's 1 ampere, right? If my current reaches 1 ampere, voltage, because this R is 1 ohm, the voltage drop across this resistance is 1 volt. Voltage drop across this inductor is 0 volt. So if it's 0 volt, current doesn't change with the time. That's a steady state, right? So at the steady state, we again, this time derivative is 0, so this is 1 volt, my IT is only 1 amp, right? So I have a DC here, I have a DC there. At this DC, this is a short circuit, this is 1 volt, my current should be 1 amp. This voltage is again 0 volt. If I plot VLT with the time, my VLT will be something like that. So this is my VLT. Okay, question. No. Yeah, what's the energy? So, what's the energy stored in this case? Energy. Energy is. So, if current is flowing. Yeah, this inductor will store magnetic energy. Okay, here is. Let's see. Yeah, if you solve this differential equation, you will find my IT equal 1 amp, this is my IT, 1 minus exponential minus T of L of R, UT. Okay, so see, the time constant, this is called time constant. Time constant will be L of R. You will find that this is has a dimension of a time. So, which energy stored here? Yeah, that energy is energy of inductor is see, something like VT IT DT. Infinity zero, because for T negative there is no energy going in. So, you know, this is IT. What's VT? Oh yeah, this VLT is only 1 volt exponential minus T of L of R UT. Okay, if you multiply those two, then you will find that the energy will be half L times 1 amp square. Okay, this will be the stored energy. We can find it. If you multiply those two, and then integrate, okay? Okay, so we just finished the LRC. Any question? No? Okay, let's move to active devices. Yeah, so see, we mentioned the passive device, RLC. Or sometimes say some mutual inductor, like a transformer. See, if I have two inductors, they are coupling together, it's like a transformer. But you can include this one inside the inductor. So we have a linear RLC and also we have a nonlinear RLC. Okay. Then we have some active devices for amplifier. Okay. The first amplifier was a vacuum tube. It was developed early 20th century, like 1900 or something like that. Okay. Yeah, the first one, diode. See, this diode is defined to be this di means two electrodes. That's a diode. Diode is a device which flows current in one direction only. Okay. Diode, current does not flow when V is negative, current flows when V is positive. That's a diode, okay? Diode flows current in one direction only. So in this vacuum tube, see, this filament heats up. Okay. There should be some cathode somewhere. cathode filament flato. Oh, there is no cathode. Okay. So assume there is some anode here. Anode. Where is my anode? Actually, this thing is only one electrode. Okay, I have anode somewhere. Okay, this is my anode. This anode is like 100 volt, or maybe 300 volt. Very large voltage. So if I heat up this, this is anode. Where is my cathode? Okay, I assume this is my cathode. So if I heat up this one, it can emit electron easily. I have such a material. If there is, it's heated up, it just emits electron. Then there is a large electric field here because of this large DC voltage. And then, so it's collected here, right? Inside this glass tube, it is a vacuum, so there is no some material inside. So this electron emitted by thermal effect goes to this anode. So there is a current flow. If this voltage is negative, like a negative minus 100 volt, electron is not attracted to this anode. There is no current flow. So current flows only anode voltage is positive. It is diode, right? So if I have a grid in between, there is a cathode something. Oh, actually, this is a cathode. Yeah, cathode material is here in the anode. Okay, because cathode and this filament is. Filament is inside this cathode, okay? So then it makes sense, okay? Then see, I have those two electrodes, right? So I have two electrodes there. So anyway, this is a cathode, this is anode. If I have a control grid close to this cathode, I have a small voltage change here, can control large current flow in between. So small grid voltage can be amplified. So if I put some resistor load in this anode, so I have three electrodes right here, right? So grid, cathode, and anode. So if I put some resistance here, say this is like 300 volt, and then this is a cathode. This is a small voltage developed. Apply small gate voltage here, and then this voltage, I have a large anode voltage, okay? So this voltage is amplified to this voltage. If I place the grid very close to the cathode, I can control current flow effectively. So it's a triode. Tri means three. All these electrodes. Triode is three electrodes. If I have three electrodes or more than that, I can amplify. Yeah, this is a semiconductor diode. Semiconductor diode is, it has two electrodes, right? So anyway, this is a diode. In the semiconductor diode, that IV characteristic, yeah, there is a diode. This is a diode notation, semiconductor diode. The voltage drop across V and I, that IV characteristic looks like that. So this is almost zero. This is exactly zero here. Current flows when V is positive. So it is a diode. Diode flows current in one direction only. Okay. So you will see this current is something like you already know that, right? VT is a thermal voltage, right? So here this is a minus IS, and this is a zero, and this explode here when V is positive. So you will see this is around 0.7 volt. Okay. later will approximate this diode like that. I equals 0, this is 90 degrees for tickle axis. Okay. For the circuit analysis, we use a very simple model. I equals 0, below 0.7 volt, above 0.7 volt is a perfect switch, perfectly on. Transistor, oh, actually, this diode is actually, we can say this is a nonlinear resistor. Diode is a nonlinear resistor, okay? It just dissipates energy, doesn't store any energy. Okay? Very nonlinear, eh? So, I can say this is a passive device, right? Actually, you can say this is related to hand. In Chinese character, there are many characters representing hand. Actually, this is also hand. So what's this? Yeah, this is you are receiving something by using two hands. Okay. So it just accept it. It doesn't give out. Okay, so this is passive device. So I can say this is a passive device. Passive device means does not amplify. Active device means amplify. Okay. To be active device, Actually, what is this? Oh yeah. Let's see. Active device is amplifying devices. So, so this is actually this is moon. But it's a simple character for meat or somebody. So I have a body. I have a this is a small knife. Eh? If I keep two small knife in the body, you can kill anybody. So that's a very capable person. If you keep two small knife inside the body, so very able person in the long Chinese. So this is a. Nung. You can do a lot of things. So this one is active. Active device means you can amplify. Small signal can be amplified into larger signal. Okay, to be active devices, we need three terminals or more than that, three electrodes. Yeah, transistor. Transistor is developed a semiconductor transistor around 1948 or something like that, right? At the Bell Lab, they called this three-terminal device. It was a bipolar transistor, bipolar junction transistor. Transistor. It's a transfer resistor. See, if you recall BJT, say there is a collector current. Emitter current and base current. So my base current, collect current is larger than my collect current is like 100 IB, much larger than base current. So resistance between base emitter is larger than resistance between collect and emitter. Okay, so they call the it just transfer the resistor. It changed the resistor, so that's why they call the transistor in short. Okay, so yeah, we have a widely used transistor, bipolar junction transistor, or MOS field effect transistor. Nowadays, we are using this complementary MOS feedback transistor in integrated circuits, right? BJT, we can find it in the lab or power devices. Yeah, this is a transistor, 3-terminal, right? I think you will use it something like that in the lab. Yeah, most transistors are mostly available in integrated circuits. Yeah, this is integrated circuit. Oh yeah, it has what's the chip? Yeah, this is a bird. I have a bird on a tree. You know, this is a tree, right? Many birds on a tree. So this is a mole chip. Okay. This is so zigzag integrated. Many transistors are stacked on a single chip. So this is Kilby's invention. He invented a transistor capacitor. They can be placed on a single substrate. That's a patent of Kilby, Texas Instruments. Yeah, those are resistor, capacitor, all circuit elements can be made of semiconductor. All circuit components can be formed on one semiconductor crystal, adding only the interconnection. He said the interconnection is outside the semiconductor. Okay. So anyway, those are patent of IC. And slightly after, Bob Noyce of Intel founder, he had planar technology. See, all elements, including interconnects, are placed on a substrate. So they fight each other for a long time. And U.S. Patent Office granted a patent to both persons. Okay. Any question about the devices? We talked about the RLC, diode, and transistor. Now we just review some circuit theory. Okay. So we'll deal about the linear time invariant system. Yeah, what's a linear system? Actually, linear system is we mostly deal with actually some transistors are nonlinear. Okay, active devices are nonlinear, but we can approximate in linear if I reduce the signal amplitude. Okay. So linear time invariant system, LTI. So in a linear time invariant system, then frequency is remains the same. So input frequency is the same. I mean output frequency is same as input frequency. So LTI system consists of a linear RLC and some dependent sources. This dependent source is like an active device, okay? Amplifier. Okay. Yeah, those are dependent sources. Voltage controlled voltage source, voltage controlled current source, current controlled sources, right? So amplifier. Yeah, this amplifier. Jumpo, okay, amplifier. Active device generate dependent sources. Right? Yeah. Active device has amplified power. Passive device just attenuated, right? No amplification. Yeah. So let's just see. Electronic devices, RLC, diode, transistor, voltage source, current source, those are sources. You know, all sensors can be modeled as a voltage source or current source with a source resistance. Those voltage source can be modeled by Thevenin equivalent circuit. So it means, see, I have a voltage source and this source resistance. This is Thevenin, right? My RS is usually small. Norton source, my RS must be, this is VS. Norton source, my RS is large, right? If RS is small, I can say this is a voltage source. For large RS, it's a current source. Okay. Yeah, what's linear? Yeah, you see, if this is, if X1 generate Y1 here, X1 generate, see, this is input. I have a system. See, this is my LTI system. If my input is X1, my output is Y1, right? If I change input to X2, my output is Y2. If I change my input linear combination of X1 and X2, my output will be sum of like that, right? That's a linear system. This is a linear superposition principle. Okay? No problem. Yeah. Let's see. Thevenin circuit. We didn't talk about Thevenin circuit much. Let's talk about Thevenin circuit a little bit more. Ideal voltage source. Ideal voltage source. See, I have something like, let's see. What's ideal voltage source? You know, ideal voltage source is like that, right? You know, this is ideal voltage source, DC voltage source. My output V is constant, right? So, in this case, it's ideal voltage source can be represented Thevenin circuit with a zero source resistance. But this is ideal voltage source, zero. RS. Ideal current source is like that, right? This ideal current source we can easily represent it by Norton with like that, with RS equal infinite open circuit, right? So voltage source, this RS must be small. Current source, this RS must be large. Okay? Okay, let's move to the unit. Any question? No? Okay, let's move to the unit. Sometimes, see, it's convenient to have a concept about the unit. So there is some standard in the unit. So it's a MKSA unit. We are mostly using MKS. So you already know MKS unit in the physics, right? Meter, kilogram, second. But we have one more, ampere. So if I have a meter is defined precisely by standard, right? Yeah, they're the same. Kilogram is defined. Second is defined. And we have one more definition of ampere. Then we can represent anything, okay? By using four basic units, you can represent any quantity. So what's ampere? Ampere is a unit of current. say it defined, say they using Ampere's law. See, Ampere's law is see, if I have two conductor and the current flowing I1 and I2, distance d, and then see the force. So if the current flowing in the same direction, they repel each other. Okay, there is some force applied here. So the force is by Ampere's law, the force per unit length is defined 2 to the 10 to the minus 7 Newton. Yeah, Newton is just a force, right? Force. And then, see, yeah, this is, I think what, D equal 1 meter. So if current is 1 ampere, the force is 2 times 10 to the minus 7 Newton. Okay? That magnitude of current is defined to be 1 ampere. Okay. Yeah, then let's see. Yeah, Coulomb charge is 1 ampere times 1 second. See, if I have a capacitor here, if I flow 1 ampere current for 1 second, there will be 1 coulomb charge accumulated here. Okay, volt. What's a volt? Volt is see work. Work equal qV. We can define joule, the energy, by using MKS units, right? Now, work is something like, what? Force times second. What's the force? Force equal, F equal MA, kilogram meter per second square. Yeah, that's MA, right? So, we can represent joule easily by MKS unit. So we can define volt, okay? And we can define even ohm. Ohm equal volt divided by ampere, because volt is here already. So by using 4 kilogram MKSA, meter kilogram second ampere, we can represent anything. This Coulomb's law could be used to define this unit, but it's not used. Force is related to charge. Okay, so they used this magnetic field definition, Ampere law, to define units. Yeah, F equal. Did I make it wrong? Okay. Joule is this energy, joule is force times distance, meter, okay, force times distance, meter. Newton, yeah, F equal MA. Acceleration, right, meter per second square. Power, yeah, horsepower, one horsepower is average horsepower, right? This is actually power is 1 horsepower is 746 watt. Watt is what? Watt is joule per second, right? That's power. So actually this watt is same as, let's see. My watt is a power, this is a joule per second. We already said my joule is coulomb times voltage, right? So this is coulomb second times voltage is I times V. So I times V is my power. Current times voltage is my power. Yeah, this ampere, see, we can reinterpret it. This is, I think this is is this Avogadro number? I'm not sure. See, this is actually, we can count, you know, the electron charge, right? Electron charge is, I think this is something like that. single electron, one electron charge is electron charge. So one ampere is 6.28 times 10 to the 18. This is inverse of it, passing through a cross section in 1 second. This directly comes from electron charge. Yeah, so yeah, sometimes you have to, it would be convenient. Energy equal Coulomb times voltage, right? Coulomb times voltage. It's consistent with other definition. Energy Coulomb times power, my power equal, you already know, current times voltage is my power. Integration of power with time, that's energy, right? My energy. So then see, this is Coulomb times voltage must be my energy. Okay, this is Coulomb, right? Yeah. Okay, say you can define ohm. What's a farad? Farad is the definition of capacitance, right? My capacitance is defined to be charge divided by voltage, right? So this farad, 1 farad is just 1 coulomb divided by volt. So 1 coulomb is ampere second divided by volt. That's my farad. Henry. Henry is see, definition of inductance is magnetic flux equal. Yeah, this is the definition of inductance Henry. So my 1 Henry is let's just see. This magnet we know that V equal flux. This is my voltage, right? So flux is L equal flux of I. I, this is ampere, this flux is volt second, right? It is true? Yeah. So we can represent any quantity in terms of MKSA unit, ampere. Yes, there are some notations here. See, we are familiar with kilo. Kilo is 1,000, right? 1,000. Well, kilo is somehow lower case, right? Mega, 10 to the 6. This is capital. Giga, 10 to the 9. Tera, 10 to the 12. Say, what else? We are using milli. Milli is lower case. Micro, lower case, nano, pico, sometimes femto, sometimes atto. You know, other quantities we don't use much, right? So I have a 1,000 hertz. So I will write this is 1 kilohertz. Okay. Yeah, any question? No? Okay. Let's review a little bit about the, because we have some time left here. Let's see. Capacitance. Did we talk about the capacitor? RC. I think we didn't do that. Okay, let's talk about the RC circuit. Okay. Yeah, my VST is again step input. Yeah, for T, see here, I can derive a differential equation. Say, what's my differential equation? So, yeah, my current will flow like that, and it will generate a charge there, right? The same current flows out there. I have a minus QT here. So, my QT equal C times V. This is capacitor voltage, right? So this should be integration IT, I tau. Yeah, so see, my VCT will be one over C integration I can hear somebody talking. Who? Oh, you. Okay, let's apply KVL here. My VST equal R times I plus VCT, right? So I can write it like down, like that. See, R times IT plus 1 over C integration I tau d tau. Yeah, see, this is a integral equation in terms of I, right? So let's try to change it into differential equation. Say then, differential equation is here. See, my IT equal C times dV dt. Then, see, the voltage drop across there is Ri, right? So my VST equal R times C dVC dt. This is VCT. So in terms of VCT, I can write a differential equation. Okay. So anyway, let's go quickly. For T negative, capacitor is open circuit. Right? Then current is zero, voltage drop is zero. My VCT should be 1 volt. Okay. This is my VCT because the capacitor is open circuit. I is a zero, IR drop is a zero there. How about here? See, for T equal positive, for DC, after long time, my capacitor is open circuit also, right? So it should be, oh, sorry, is this 1 volt? Sorry, it should be zero. Sorry about that. Because this is a zero, this is a zero, this is a zero. So it will change like that, right? So something like, yeah, this is my capacitor voltage. Say, my capacitor current, I mean this current will change like that. Zero. This should be 1 amp exponential t over RC ut. Okay? So if you integrate the energy stored here, which is IT, VT, DT, you can see this is 1/2 V square. V is 1 volt, right? So that's the energy stored in the capacitor. Okay, let's finish here.